The first thing you'll want to focus on is something I like to call your concept equation, which should be conveyed within the first few sentences of your application. Developing this early on is incredibly important for writing your research questions and maintaining focus in your research abstract. And it will also help the reviewer quickly focus on the problem you identify and your proposed intervention. Start with your identified health disparity population. As an example, you might choose to look at Hispanic or Latino men in the United States. Selecting a specific population doesn't mean your intervention couldn't help other populations, but the reviewers want to see that you've been thoughtful in trying to address a problem for a specific market. Next, describe the problem you've identified. In this case, you might choose to address high rates of high blood pressure in that specific population. Then you'll discuss your intervention and why it's an improvement over any of the current interventions on the market. Maybe you believe that a lack of culturally competent and accessible preventative care is the biggest barrier for this population as they try to manage their hypertension. And you're proposing to use mobile units staffed by specially trained, multilingual clinicians to improve access to care. Lastly, be sure to discuss how your intervention would improve health equity for that specific population. This first part of your application is where you'll discuss the how and the what of your intervention. So you want to ensure the reviewers understand your research question, the population and problem you'll be targeting, and the basics of your proposed intervention. This grant is an investment by NIMHD to support and further the Institute's objectives. So you also want to continually re-emphasize how your intervention would create, support, or improve health equity. It's also critical to ensure your application is responsive to the funding notice you're applying for. I've seen applications disqualified numerous times because they propose an intervention that is not within the scope of the funding opportunity, and the review board finds them to be non-responsive. The funding notice will also have information on the specific interest of the Institute, so please also keep those in mind while you're preparing your application. For example, if NIMHD is looking for digital clinical services and your application focuses on a non-digital method of alleviating patient food insecurity, that intervention will be found to be non-responsive to the funding notice, regardless of whether or not the reviewers feel the intervention is a good one. You'll also want to ensure your application includes a hypothesis and preliminary outcome data on how your intervention will improve health equity in your specific market and/or with your identified population. This hypothesis should be informed by any preliminary data you've already gathered. There should also be some discussion of how you'll continue to capture data from your identified population and how that data will contribute to a strong commercialization plan for a phase two application. In addition, you'll need to talk about why your product or approach is an improvement over other interventions that are currently on the market. Talk about why your competitors aren't delivering this kind of intervention, and how your approach would improve health equity for your chosen population. How will your intervention better serve this population? Will it make existing processes more efficient? Will it better meet your population's needs in some way? And if so, how? You want to make your case to reviewers that your proposed intervention will be a meaningful improvement over existing options. The highest scoring applications always use their aims pages to discuss how they're going to actually implement the strategy they're proposing. So make sure that you are clearly tying your research aims to practical actions. For example, maybe one of your aims is to develop a prototype for an online professional development course to train clinicians in more culturally competent ways to address hypertension in Latino men. You might include specific objectives, such as recruiting Latino men, for focus groups to inform the development of the prototype. developing the prototype, pilot testing the prototype with both Latino men and clinicians, and iterating on the prototype based on feedback from those populations. Those are specific, actionable steps you'll take to demonstrate your proof of concept, which is a critical part of this application. Lastly, watch for common traps and make sure you're addressing potential concerns reviewers might have, such as how you would handle HIPAA and any privacy concerns, navigate institutional review boards, design clinical trials, and ensure you have people with the right kinds of expertise on your team and in your biographical sketches. Applicants must take into consideration that reviewers will be reading 50 or more applications and will experience fatigue. Make sure from the beginning that there's no doubt about what your research question is, what intervention you're proposing, and which health disparity population or populations you are targeting with your concept. Checking these boxes will go a long way toward ensuring you'll have a quality application. But it's also important to tell a story about why you're applying for a specific opportunity. Whether it's because you're a parent who struggled with a lack of cultural competency in previous interactions with your child's pediatrician, or you've experienced food insecurity that has led to a worsening of a chronic illness, this is the only time you'll be talking to the reviewers, and it is critical that you be able to convey why you're passionate about your intervention.